There we go. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, is this out of frame? Yeah, it is actually out of frame. Add audio levels. Looks good. Okay, great. How's everybody doing? Okay, looks like there's no... Just checking the background noise here. Levels just looks like they're okay. We have Chief Dog, John, Ashade, Quasar, Andy, the awesome Pickle, Gwikhan, Beer Keg, Don Galore, of course, is here. Just Joe, Tura, Gary, and we have I Am Kosh, we have Sinuin, Struk, and Altslay over on Twitch. William, Android, Plus, Commander Silverwolf, I think I'm trying to get everybody. Woopools, Sylvian, and Gemons. Okay, lots of people. Dark Side there. Pete is also here. Good evening, everybody. How is everybody doing? So, we're going to talk about the plan for the stream today. I'm already running out of water. We're going to... Okay, I can't pronounce that, but thanks a lot for the follow on Twitch. And we're going to start out with... Black Lion Run making the first of all firsts with a $5 donation. Thanks a lot, saying first. Indeed. Thank you very much. It is very much appreciated. Please try to pronounce it. I wouldn't even know how to start. We don't even know the characters, then it's difficult. Okay. So... Before we dive into live stream, I just want to hear what are your guys' thoughts on the Dev Diary. I figure someone's gonna ask anyway, so we might as well get this out of the way. What do you guys think about it? You know, if you've seen my video, of course you will know what I think about it. Yeah, Brian says it's great. There was one thing I noticed while reading comments. Yeah, I agree with John there. It's too little info. As I also mentioned in the video I posted, I would like him to have seen them go even more in depth with more, like, even deeper, even more technical stuff. Maybe even begin to show us some in-game. I know that they are very early. They are still pre-alpha, so it will be very early days, but everybody knows it's early days with these kind of stuff, so I wouldn't mind that. Let me see what else people are saying. Dev Diary May. Yeah, okay. I think that also the main thing I would really like to see even more. Could the planet have used it in engineering? Maybe. Perhaps. That would require new blueprints or altering of the existing blueprints. Just trying to keep up in chat. Planets look great. Will there be anything to do except life and exploration? See, that's what we... Yes, so there will be. What they have done so far in the first Dev Diary here is focus on the exploration side of it, and only that. They haven't done anything else. So they're just talking about exploration, and that means there will probably be combat. We've seen so many people run around with weapons, so there will probably be some point-and-shoot combat gameplay as well for the more... for the more combat-oriented, and who knows? Maybe, I mean, we already have material collection in SRVs. Maybe they're going to introduce a new mining mechanic, like hand mining, where you go up with a pickaxe and you go all Minecraft on the rocks or something. I don't know. So I can see potential for lots of activities on foot on Planet Services. And I agree, that looks very, very good, graphical-wise. And I think what they've done with exploration is Minecraft dangerous, or elite Minecraft, depending on how you want to flip around. But yeah, I would definitely also like to see more. We also have to remember this is the first Dev Diary. I can understand why Frontier maybe do not want to go out and begin to post gameplay footage in this early stage. So hopefully we're going to begin to see stuff like that down the road. As we get closer to release, they will probably be able to have more and more of the stuff where they've settled in. They've they've decided on where they want to go with that direction. So we can actually begin to see some still half finished, but at least some working gameplay or stuff like that. And as also mentioned in the video, I really want to, I really hope that we're going to begin to get some more nitty gritty with the developers. Instead of it just being an interview, I wouldn't mind if the videos were longer. I wouldn't mind if they were 20 minutes long and just gave the developers, like, talk about what you've been doing. Why was this difficult, or why was this easier, and how have you done it? Like, how was those plans generated? Was it just a art thing, or did you actually have someone in and consulted someone who has knowledge about plans? I don't know. Anyway, let's go and let's dive into the live stream for tonight. So, I've been doing this before for the longest time. My main ship that I by far spend the most time in, John, I'm from Denmark, but the ship I've spent the most time in is my Camera Conda. It is an Anaconda build that is designed to basically be a flying camera. So it's something that the ship doesn't necessarily have to look good itself. Because I'm often not recording the ship itself, but I just need to carry all the equipment that I use when I go out and I do recordings. Barry, thanks a lot for the donation. JP, that's Japanese yen, of course. Yes, thank you very much. So let me just quickly get in here to the shipyard and let me get the Camera Conda ready so we can go and have a look at the current build. Here we go. Attempt number, is the third attempt? I think it might be the third attempt. Okay, give me a quick second here and I'm gonna get the Camera Conda built up as it is today. There we go. And let's jump in and have a look. So this is the build as it is today. Again, designed for carrying me around the bubble, so long jump range Anaconda, relatively long jump range, 62 light years. And it basically has everything I need for basically going anywhere I need. A fuel scoop so I can scoop. It does happen that I want to go out and record something far away, and in cases like that, it's nice to have a fuel scoop. Shield generator because I fly into everything that I see. Some cargo, a frameshift drive booster for longer range, recon limpet, fighter hangar. The fighter hangar is so they use the fighters as camera drones, essentially, so I can go out, go into third person with a camera, and I have a very mobile ship I can use to record with. Okay, so that's a very good question here from Just Joe. Camera Conda seems like a solid, seems pretty solid. Why is the need for a new ship? Because I am tired of flying the Anaconda. I've been flying it so much, I want something smaller, more nimble, something that's a little bit more fun to fly. Oh, that's my fleet carrier jumping here in the background. Obviously, an SRV hangar. Collector limpets are also very nice to have, especially if it's a larger ship. Research limpets, not sure how much I'm going to need those. Detailed service scanner. And apparently I have a supercruise assist on it. Right, I do have a supercruise assist on it. And then I have kill wound scanner, manifest scanner, sinus scanner, and frameshift drive wake scanner. Fleet carriers are very nimble to fly. So the way I want to approach this, just jump in and because in a second this is going to begin to be really noisy. So what I'm just going to do is I'm going to mute in-game audio, and then I'm going to forget to put it back on later, and you guys will remind me. Yes, it will need a lot of internals. So what I want to do is to make a list of components that I will need or criteria that I have. And I basically want to make like, let's call this one must have. Wow. Try that again. Fingers today. God damn it. There we go. Must have. And there must be some nice to have. If room. So basically this is the list that we're gonna go and we're gonna create. I'm gonna create a list with stuff that I will absolutely need on the ship. Stuff that if there's room it would be really nice to have. And no, not if there's room. This would be nice to have. And this one is just if there's room, I can put it on. It's not really necessary. So we gotta put that down there. So in the must have, let's go with, let's start, we must have a good jump range. I would say 50 plus light years is probably the minimum I can, I will work with. And I would agree also, Quasar, yeah, I will probably need a fuel scoop. I would need two SRVs because it happens that I go out and have to do some recording that involves an SRV exploding or I accidentally explode an SRV doing a recording. So having two SRVs has been a lifesaver in the past. So I definitely want that. Shield, because it doesn't have to be big, just any shield is pretty much as long as it's more than like, I don't know, 200 plus hit points. Like, I don't know if it's a small ship, then 200 hit points is a lot. Any shield, pretty much. Jump range plus fuel scoop. Why not use fleet carriers that have those? And because it. Yeah, I could just jump the fleet carrier out if I wanted. I think I could maybe omit the fuel scoop if I can get. I just hate moving the fleet carrier around too much. You can hear the background, but you can't unmute it. Ha. A jump is faster. I mean, for moving around the bubble, jumping is a lot faster. I don't want to move my fleet carrier every time I have to go and visit any small location. I have my fleet carrier relatively static. The only reason why I'm moving it now was because I went down to the Pleiades sector. And I didn't feel like flying down there and then waiting for the ship transfer. Then I just jumped down there. Because that was probably faster than doing a ship transfer. Hello, Crimburn. So what else do we need? I need some cargo. If I need to pick stuff up. We're gonna prefer to have corrosive. How much do we need cargo? Minimum 4 ton. What about, I don't necessarily need a hangar. Gotta put this up here. We're gonna need fighter or ship with good menu. That's probably not right. Oh, that's not right. There we go. So either a fighter hangar, good maneuverability. What about limpets? I don't think. I mean, the limpets for the fleets, for the mega ships. What is that? Is that the That's the recon limpet. So I do want a recon limpet controller. So we have the SR. I don't need the research. That's just the one for collecting Thargoid stuff. Yeah, Recode is for hacking things, exactly, and I think I want that. And I would actually put this recon here down to a nice to have together with a collector. Because I can make do without these two, but they would be nice to have. You know what, we're just gonna, I'm not gonna put anything down in if room anyway. In terms of utilities, I'm going to need a... and frames to drive wake scanner. And I think that's actually it. The nice to have, I'm gonna put a... You know what, actually, I'm gonna reinstate the if room. We want a research limpet, and we also want a Xeno scanner if there's room. We can also put a Killworn scanner in if there's room. And Xeno scanner, Killworn scanner. What about the manifests? Manifest, I would say, is that's a nice to have. Manifests. Manifest scanner. Oh, right. Thank you, Donkalora. Detailed surface scanner, of course. Yes. So now we can begin to count. If we're going to go for something that can complete both must and need to have, then we need one, two, I'm just counting optional internals. 1, 2, 3, 4. Five, six, and seven. Internal seven. Utility. One. Two. Okay. Seven internals and two utilities. Now, of the ship that I have considered that I wanted to work with was either, whoops, that was not what I wanted to do, was either of the Diamondbacks, either the Phantom, or either of the Asps. So now we can, so those are the five ships that I've wanted to, but I can also see something like, probably not the Beluga, that's too big and heavy, but something like a Dolphin could be fun. Or an Orca maybe, if we want to go. Now that's a large one, I don't want a large ship, I want something that's small or medium. You know what we're going to do? We're going to try something completely different here. Let's just take this, sort it by size, and then we're going to look at the, whoops, at the, where's the internals? Oh, they're out there, they're out here. Which ships have seven internals? Six, the Cobra Mark III has. There's a lot that has that, isn't there? Explorer has it. Nah, you know what? Let's not, because that's going to be too long of a list. A lot of people saying Python. I just... Trademark 2 for the... yeah, okay. Let's try to select a few builds here. Just to start with some of them, and then we can always see if we come with, up with... Some of the people say Keelback. I've seen that a few times. People suggesting that. I don't want the Orca, but I do want the Asps. That. I want to check the Phantom. And Mark II for the... I don't know if I want to do with the Mark II for the fighter hangar. Let's just go see if all of these... Okay, so already here we can see the Diamondback Scout is out for only having six internal slots. This is 8. This is also plenty. 7. And the Asp Scout is... Oops. God. Did I remove that now? Oh, God. So, Asp Explorer. Dolphin was okay. Group highlighted ships. Oh, okay. Nice. Ah, that's nice. Thank you. That one was still working. Keelback. Phantom. Where's the Phantom? Crate. The Cratest Phantom. There it is. Let's just do it again. So the Crate Phantom has 5 plenty of internals. The Keelback has 4, 5, 6, 7. Just exactly enough. And it has, the Dolphin has 5, plenty, okay. Yeah, exactly, as people also posting, with good thrusters, I don't need the fighter. On the Anaconda, you can see I've downgraded the thrusters for better jump range, because I used the fighter for maneuverability. But if I don't have a fighter, I'll just gonna upgrade the thrusters. Yeah, because... Oh, right. Hold on. Yeah, so that would need the ship-launched fighter, but does it have room for that? 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. No, so that's not enough room for it, because we need that extra one for the ship-launched fighter. Kapper, I'm talking both to Twitch and to YouTube. You can follow the chat on screen if you want to. Crate Mark 2 it is then. Okay, we can look at... Okay, let's start by going and make a sample build on these 4 ships. And then we take... Whatever is best of that. And then we might also just go and do a test with some other ships. But I think I want to start with just doing Asp Exploder, Diamondback Exploder, Dolphin, and Phantom. Okay, let's start by stripping this ship down. Let's get some good thrusters in, good frameshift drive, derate the life support, derate the sensors, and this one... I'm just going to throw in an A power distributor for now. I don't know what to do with it, but I'll do that later. Dirty drive, drag drives. Increase range, this is a 5, so this is going to be mass manager. Life support is going to be, it's going to be lightweight. Power distributor, we don't know. Sensors, it's going to be, it's going to be lightweight. Let's get all this here. Where are we at for jump range? We're good. With fuel is the one we're looking at, so we're still good here. We need a surface scatter. Yeah. We need some cargo, some shields, a scoop, 2 SRVs. hangar, sanitary vehicle hangar. We need a full what? I can't remember. Four G apparently. We need that. Then, how many do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We have had one extra slot. So what if we put a fuel scoop in here? Oh, that's a fuel tank. That's not what I want. 3A fuel scoop. Scoop time is 3 minutes. What do I actually have on the Conda? 25 seconds. That's always been the problem with the Diamondback Explorer. Now we're fitting a smaller fuel scoop again. But it's not a big deal with the long scoop times. Yeah, I was just looking at the mast, that's why I chose which planetary vehicle, like I can remember which one was the lighter one. So we have the SRV, we need the cargo. Okay, we need a collector and a recon limpet. One a collector. Not we want those down there. I probably want the recon limpet down here. Recon limpet controller. Boom, you go in there. If you have one slot spare, use two. Oh, yeah, but I want to see if I can't squeeze in some of the if room kind of things. So what do I still need? I have a fuel scoop, I have my SRVs, I need my shields. I probably have to go with a shield generator here. I think that's the smallest. Yeah. We're going to go with a bi-weave, I think. Just because I don't need a whole lot of hit points. I just need enough to take the accidental bumps and scratches. But it's a good point, Donald. We might be able to use that later. Now we need diesel, so we have that wake scanner. Oh, we need the collector and cargo. One a collector. So I could either go with a class 2 to get 4 tons or with a 1 to get 1 ton of corrosive. That's not enough. That is a absolute bare minimum. Yeah, but I don't think with a Python that I'm going to be able to push it up over the 50 light years that I want. So I have an extra slot now. I could potentially upgrade some things here. Put in a bigger fuel scoop, maybe. Okay, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to upgrade the fuel scoop. For a fuel scoop. Gonna keep that little planetary vehicle hangar there. Gonna upgrade this to a 3A collector limpet controller. Gonna drop that. And then down here we now have a class 2 slot we can use for something fun. We have recon. We need the manifest. We need the stuff over here, but this is just, we have 4 slots. This is plenty. We could put in the research limpet, for instance. Was that one of the things on the list? Yeah. And then over here, we put in a manifest scanner. We put in a kill wound scanner. We can pull in a Xeno scanner. Killmore scanner, Xeno scanner, manifest scanner. Oh, an awake scanner. Oh, that's not it. Pulse wave analyzer. Wake scanner, there we go. Not Crimper, not going far enough that an AFMU is needed. Okay, we have a bit of a power problem, but that could be solved. Like that. We could probably also say, do I really need a... I mean, all these scanners here, I could just go, say, D-rate. They're not really lighter, but... I would probably say something like the Manifest Scanner, the Killworn Scanner. I probably want the range of the Killworn Scanner if I need it up, but it's not going to go into any combat anyway. And the Xeno Scanner is all going to be D-rated. I can't do anything with the Xeno Scanner. The Frenzy Wake Scanner, I do want that high, and then I'm going to go Fast Scan. And these, I'm going to go Fast Scan as well. Which is really nice. That should give me quite a bit of power headroom, allowing me to dump this down to a class 3 with overcharged and thermal spread. Nope. With overcharged and no effect? No. Overcharged and monster spread should be just enough to keep it flying. I can do a lot with, like, I can turn all things here and there, but for now, let's just keep that here just as a point of comparison. Yeah, I will probably have to synthesize. With a build like this, I would have to synthesize the limpets as we go. And we have just 4 tons. We can exactly have one synthesis of limpets in our cargo hold. And I won't be carrying limpets around. And we got just over the 50. So this would be a possible replacement. Let's try with Dolphin. Let's do something similar here. Oh, I didn't do any on the power distributor, did I? No. I will engineer it if I actually built the ship, but I just don't want to do it right now. Dirty drive, drag drive, increase range, and deep charge because it's a class 4. And lightweight. And lightweight. Okay. We're gonna need a surface scanner. That's always the easy one to start with, right? And then we had the recon limpet, which only comes in, I believe only comes in the 1E, right? It actually comes in a size 3 also, but maybe even 5 as well, but I don't need that. So let's put that recon limpet controller down there. We need a fuel scoop. Let's use a class 4 for that to start with. Could always upgrade later. And it's going to be an A-rated fuel scoop. We need 2 of these, so we need at least to allocate a class 4 slot for that. So, put that in there. We need a shield. Let's use a class 3 for that. Plug in a bi-weave there. Oh, yeah, there's a lot of engineering we haven't done on this at all. I mean, we also have a lot of power. I didn't engineer the shields. I haven't engineered any of this stuff, like expanded probes. Here I would probably go with something like, let's balance out the resistance. No, but it's not for combat. So even though it's kinetic, even though it is bi-weaves, I would probably go reinforced fast charge. Should I put prismatics on? I don't know. I'm gonna fine tune that later. Just want to see if power, we could actually still do this. Okay. And then lightweight that And that should actually be okay. Giving us a little bit more jump range. Okay. Where we are dolphin wise, we're not doing too well in the jump range here. This is not gonna be able to make my the 50 without, I mean, we're gonna begin to put stuff on now. So I think we have to scrap the dolphin. I want more jump range. Oh, hold on. The dolphin has quite a few extra slots, right? We might actually be able to, yeah, use an FSD booster. Hold on, where are we at here? Fuel scoop, two SRVs, we have a shield. We need cargo. Recon. And the, okay, so I need my cargo, recon, and collector. So, would be the same as before. Recon, Dempy controller. No, research. And collector. And FSD booster. Putting us out of power. But if we go ahead and overcharge the power plant, we do the same thing here with reinforced fast charge. I don't know, but just throw something on there. We have quite a bit of power now. And now we're just up at the same range as we were before. We have three utility slots, so what are we going to put those in there? Wake scanner, manifest scanner, and then either a Xeno scanner or a Killborn scanner. So we need a... Wake scanner. A... Was it manifest we agreed on? Yeah, manifest. And then put a Xeno scanner in there. Power, overpowered. So we're gonna go that down to a D. And we're good again. Yeah, Killborn scanners are useful, but sometimes, I don't know, it just could be fun to have it around. I mean, if you come across something and you want to scan it, I don't know. Just Joe says, just hit the like button. Thank you very much. If you guys are enjoying the stream, please do go down and do the same. Okay, I think we have the same cargo as the other one. So just comparing the Dolphin and the Explorer. Scoop times are better. Unladen jump range is slightly better than the Diamondback. Not a lot to make a big difference. Total range. Little better on the Explorer. What about speed wise? Ooh, Dolphin is quick. And it carries everything we need. I don't really need the manifest. I mean, we can just put fast scan on these. Fast scan on that. And fast scan on this as well. There we go. Still plenty of power. Again, the power distributor has not received any upgrades. But I'll probably just do a pretty standard, like, charge enhanced supercapacitor. Okay, for now I think I actually like the Dolphin a little bit better. I mean, it has more hit points, it has, yeah, a small decrease in jump range, but it's not too bad. Imperial Courier, I don't think the Imperial Courier has enough internal slots to do that. Oh, that's gonna be tough. It has enough, but it's gonna be tough. Okay, let's quickly do the Phantom just to keep this thing rolling. I'm just gonna quickly do the exact same as before with all of these. Ooh, class 7. Ooh, we're definitely working with something slightly bigger than what we had before. Let's go ahead and lightweight and lightweight and... Oh, was that a fast charge you put on there? Yeah. Increase range mass manager. Thrusters is gonna get, whoops, dirty drive. Drag drives. Okay. We can put in the surface. Surface scanner. Yes, we might have to look at the courier as well. Okay. Phantom. We can also put in that was the recon limpet, right? Yeah, we only need one active limpet, so we can put that in the lower slot as well. SRV, we know we need at least a class 4 slot, so that goes here. Always start with the ones that are limited. Shields. 5 or 3. I've got to go with a 5. And again, bi-weaves. And again, just, I don't know, I'm not sure if this is the one I'm going to end with in terms of engineering, but I'm just putting stuff in right now to get things going. So fuel scoop, we need a fuel scoop. We need some cargo. You know what, this is actually, we could actually put an FSD if I can. Where are we at jump range wise? Ooh, that's the start. What have I done wrong here? Increase range of the manager. It's not gonna jump far enough. We might be able to save a little bit of weight here and there. Cargo rack. Collector. Right, the research limpet comes only in one, so we can move that up and take a 3A recon. And there we actually have. Apart from that, we need to do the power plant, and we need to work on our jump range, because it's not good enough right now. But we need to put in the same loadout as here, right? Wake scanner, manifest scanner, and sino scanner. The wake scanner. The derated manifests. The sino. And what's the last one? We was considering a kill worn, but... Nah. Gonna leave that. Did I put that on the Diamondback? Yeah. Probably scrap that, but to be honest, I don't need the kill worn scanner. Put fast scan on these. Heat sink. Yeah, we have an extra utility slot. We can always So we actually have quite a bit of power headroom that we can work with here. Probably allowing us to drop our power plant down. Yeah. If we keep the distributor, maybe we can save a little bit here by derating the distributor, because do we really need that much? Charge enhanced, cluster capacitor. There's something I would probably also do in the other ones to fine tune them, but again, we're just working. So we overcharge this and thermal spread. Okay, can we do this on a class 4 power plant? With overcharged. Ooh, this is gonna be damn close. Hoo-hoo-y. Can we save a little bit somewhere? Because then we actually have something that's pretty close. Yes, it must be able to boost, obviously. Jump range is up in the same area as we were up here. I mean, there's by 0.3 or something of a light year difference. We just need to save... Oh, hold on. Oh, in the wrong ship. Ha! We just need to save a little bit of power, and I could begin to disable modules. Like, the easiest way with this would be to say, okay, I'm just going to disable the ones I'm never really using, the scanners. Like, the frameshift wake scanner, that's not something you use in a hurry. Right. The wakes tend to stick around for a bit. Or I could just go and say, okay, you've got to go B-rated fast scan with that one instead. I lose a bit of range, but yeah. Or I could just remove the Xeno scanner and many options here, right? But overall, let's keep that there. Scoop time, 36 seconds. That's the best so far. Jump range is also up there. Total range is up and pretty much matching what we got in the Explorer. Speed wise, we're actually the fastest we've seen so far. Why do we have an adder here? That's not the ship I want. What was the last one? Explorer, Dolphin. Asp, of course. The Crate Phantom is a good ship. Everybody's going Beluga. What part of I don't want a big heavy ship doesn't you guys don't get? I don't want something that's big and heavy that I have. Anaconda? No. No, give me Asp. Oh, there it is. What? Now it opened up the Imperial. Okay, Imperial Courier, we're apparently going to check that. And I'm going to check the Asp Explorer as well. Okay, this grouping thing is not working. There we go. Okay, let's just because people seem to be quite keen on the courier. If we could get a courier to work, I would love that. We can get performance enhanced thrusters, meaning this thing is gonna be quick. Look at that. This one is gonna be very quick. I'm gonna love that getting in and out of stations. Gonna put a good FSD on that's gonna get increased range with deep charge because small one. D-rate, lightweight, D-rate, lightweight, power distributor, go there. How are we for jump range? We need to do something about that jump range. This is going to be difficult, guys. Maybe we can do something with the power plant to lighten the weight a bit. With these small ships, I think dropping a few tons can make a huge difference. And we're just going to start from the bottom. Okay, we already have a problem here because the Imperial Courier... have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, it might just work. Planetary vehicle hangar. We need 2 planetary vehicle hangars. We need a surface scanner. We need a recon limpet controller. I need a fuel scoop. I need a shield. Shield, cargo. And then... shield generator. You know what? We can actually dump that down to a class 2. Yeah, we're gonna work with an FDS book, so I'm gonna drop this down to a class 2C with reinforced fast charge. Plenty of hit points there. Hold on, there's something we're missing here. 1, 2. I'm missing my cargo rack. Get 2 tons of cargo in there. Fuel scoop. SRV, shields, cargo, detail, surface scanner. We have the recon. See, I will probably drop the recon then, it's nice to have. And then swap that out for a collector. And lightweight that. And then put in an FSD booster. We need to save some mass here, guys. Let's just finish putting in the other modules over there. We just need the wake scanner. And in the interest of saving mass, just put this down to a D-rated. Not because it's lighter. That doesn't really make a big difference. But that means it doesn't use as much power, so we can dump the power plant, probably down to a class 3 overcharged. Oh yeah, wow. Can we go even lower? Can we go to class 2 overcharged? We can. Ooh. And then this one is we need to save. I don't think we're gonna get. Yeah, I need the. Okay, so problem is the cargo is small. Our jump range is not short enough. The courier is just not gonna make it. It's just not good enough. Nuke 3 is right. A rookie. Enhanced low power shields. Yeah, I guess there's some of the way there. Is those two hangers. Those 2 times 6 tons there is. Yeah, I agree, Darkseid. It's an awesome ship. I love the courier. I mean, what I could do was then to compromise and say only one hangar. Then we're beginning to get up there, but we are still like 8 light years short. Dolphin does look like a decent, and I would love to have the Dolphin. It's a great looking ship as well. Let's just, for good measures, do the obvious choice and build a Asp Exploder. Dirty drive. Drag drive, FSD, with, whoops, increased range and mass manager. D-rate the life support and lightweighted. A-rate that with a, whoops, with a charge enhanced and. No, should we go super conduit? Let's go super conduit. D-rate that and lightweight that. And here we put a surface scanner in. And here we have a wake. Kill war. Wake. There we go. Frames with wake scanner with fast charge, or fast scan. Ooh. We need that class 5 slot for the hangar. We probably want to use this for the fuel. No, we can probably dump the fuel scoop a bit. Oh, let's use it for fuel. Fertilance, I don't think we're going to get a good jump range out of Fertilance. No, not shields. What am I doing? Focus. Fuel scoop. Lord Winter, by the way, thanks a lot for the donation. I think it's too big or too short of a jump range. We're actually a little short on jump range in the Asp Exploder. Oh wait, I haven't upgraded this. That's probably gonna help a bit. But given how much stuff we still have to put in here, it might actually be that this is not gonna... It's not gonna work. I don't know, can we put a shield in here? 3A shield generator. Yes, we can. Enhanced low power and fast charge. Recon. Cargo. Collector. Collector's going to be lightweighted. Fuel scoop, SRV, shield, cargo, detailed surface scanner, wake scanner, recon, collector, and we can put a manifest scanner in there if we have power for it. And then an FSD booster here. It's not terrible. The range is good. The jump range is obviously good now. And speed is also decent. But I've never been a big fan of the Asp Explorer, I must admit. Yeah. So the only thing I have with all these builds is that I have no corrosive cargo. That means if I have to go and do anything at all that involves Thargoid stuff and I have to go and pick stuff up regarding that, I can't without corroding my trip to the camera conda. That's an interesting proposal. Okay, let's just... I'm not gonna dump the fuel scoop, I'm just gonna try something here. If I needed corrosive resistance cargo, I would need at least a class 4 slot to allocate for that. That's a tall order. For a fuel scoop. That is a pretty tall order to ask for a ship of this size to carry 4 tons of corrosive. 4 tons of cargo at all, with this much other things on board. Why armor and thermal the power plant? Armor would increase the range, or increase the mass. Instead of overcharged, that just gives me more heat. Yeah, but we have not powers. Okay, any other ships we should look at before we move on and begin to Lopez has stripped the shield. Yeah, but the heat is not a big issue for me. Any other suggestions for ships we should look at while we're at it? Yeah, we have the Phantom right here. Find a ship you love flying and make it work. That's actually a Python, Beluga. Okay, everybody's saying Beluga. It's just, it's gonna be hell to land that thing, anything. Okay, we have enough room for stuff at least, but let's just, for shits and giggles, let's do this. Lightweight, increased range, and mass manager, thrusters, dirty drive, drag drives, power plant, let's wait with that. We also have a wish for a Mamba. I'm not sure that's gonna work, but we can try. We're gonna put a surface scatter in there. I don't know what to do with all these internal slots. The class 4 slot's gonna be our hangar. Then we're gonna put cargo here. 4 corrosive. What am I gonna do with all this space? Big fuel scoop, I guess. And put an FSD booster in here, yeah. Ah, we're getting there. Two SRVs done. We need a shield. Probably need to fit a class 6 shield then. Shield generator. We can of course dump it, and let's try to go with the same tactic as before with low powered. We can go strip down, but it's 5% mass. We probably have to in this case if we want to have any chance of this thing flying. No, you can't fit 2 FSD boosters, only 1. Yeah, I need to work on thermal management, but we can probably do something with the power plant here because I think we're gonna have plenty of power headroom. Shields, we had the cargo. You see, that's also, Lord Winter, you're absolutely right. Thanks for the donation again. That's also why I was really reluctant to take a large ship, because I hate landing these ships on planets. Recon limpet, collector limpet. We should have the recon limpet controller. Oh, right. I need room for a fighter, because this is not mobile enough. It's really struggling on range here. I'm sorry, but I'm not happy with the Beluga. I know it's a pretty ship, but I like the Dolphin more, I must admit. Let's try that Mamba, just for fun. I've never really thought of the Mamba as being an option. But 1, 2, 3. There's only 6 internals. We needed 7 as a minimum. So that's a no-go. What about the Orca? Again, it's a large ship, but I'm not sure the Phantom. I kinda like the Dolphin, I must admit. But the Orca is large as well. So landing is going to be interesting. But it's not as large as many of the other. Drop ships? Really? Yeah, can you get a drop ship to jump that far? I never really thought of the Alliance and the Federation ships as being jumping ships. This run is pretty sort this by size. Let's look at the some of the medium offerings here. Type 6. Scout. Just for fun. See what you can do on type 6. Yeah, we already looked at the... Didn't we already look at the keelback? And I think the verdict was 7 slots, so there's no room for... Type 6 is too hard. There's no room for a fighter hanger in here, but we can try just for fun. Let's just do this here real quick. Vehicle hanger. And I probably need to put a increased range and mass manager on this. See, this one has, it only has the 7 slots, barely has the 7 slots we need, and we are already, we have those, so we don't have room for any FSD boosters, and we have 12 light years over our target jump range. I think Peter's right. I think we're gonna go, I think what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna close down this and this, and we're gonna go and we're gonna try to refine the Dolphin build. So let's try to take the Dolphin and the Phantom. Oh, hello, Scorp. How are you doing? So just for the, we just had Scorpius over on Twitch who sent a raid party over to say hello to the chat. So just to give you a quick recap of what we're doing, I've decided that it's time that my camera ship, my camera Conda, is getting a well-earned rest, and I need a replacement. So right now I'm working on finding that replacement. And right now the battle is between Dolphin and the Great Phantom as two options. And what we're doing right now is I'm gonna go ahead and we're gonna try to refine these builds a little bit. We're just drawing like a rough sketch up so far. We're gonna begin to refine these to see how much we can push out of these ships. And hopefully it's gonna be a new ship that I'm gonna be able to fly. And oh, we'll start by building. Yeah, I'm actually, people are saying over on Twitch saying Phantom all the way, surely. I'm actually leaning a bit towards the Dolphin. Okay, one thing I want to do is I want to heavy duty deep plate the armor. It's free. It costs some materials, obviously, but we don't gain any mass from doing that, and it gives us a ton of extra armor hit points. That means I'm not going to blow up that easily when I eventually crash this thing into something. We're going to keep an eye on our power levels. Thrusters. Because we don't carry a fighter, I do want the A-rated thrusters, and I think keeping those 30-drive drag drives on is fine. The frameshift drive, not much we can do here. Same with life support and sensors. The power distributor, I could drop that, because I don't need this heavy of a distributor. I just need to be able to boost. So let's begin to see where we can go. Either I just want something that is as light as possible. And so here we're going out to 2 tons. Can I make do with a 2A? If I go, I can boost on a 2A. I can even boost on a 1D maybe if I go and then go engine focused. Yes, with a 1D engine focused super conduit. I can boost every 13 seconds. That's a little long. So maybe we gotta sacrifice 0.8 tons of mass to go up and get a 1A, also with engine focused. Actually, you know what? Can we boost with now with charge enhanced? I think we can. Charge enhanced super conduit, meaning while we boost at 11 seconds. That's a little bit better. I actually don't think necessarily when we have enough capacitor. No, I don't care how many boosts I get. I just need the capacitor, and I'm just worried about the time between boosts. Why don't we ever see these awful crashes that you speak of? Because I have a tendency to edit them out of the videos. No fight on my camera ship. No, the idea we're trying, I'm trying to work with is to get a small ship and then just get some good thrusters on it so I can use the ship itself as the camera vessel rather than the fighter. Problem is, if I have to carry a fighter, I'm pretty much locked into the Krait Mark II or the, I mean, if I want something that's smaller, more maneuverable, I'm pretty much forced to go and go the Krait Mark II route. And while the Krait Mark II is a great ship, where am I sitting? In my office. If it's the fan noise, it's because otherwise I'm gonna overheat. I'm running efficient right now to cool myself down. I think you're right, Donglora, that the Dolphin is maneuverable enough that it's not really needed. Oh, what Twist says, saying, love the office upgrade video. I'm actually considering doing another little office upgrade, because there's a few changes that I want to do to the office, including getting... I have a really cool idea, I think, for a very clean VR setup. I haven't set VR up in the new office yet, so no VR yet. So that's one thing I want to set up, and I have a really cool idea for a very clean setup. And I want to move the microphone. Right now the microphone is right here. And every time I turn and I talk this way, so when I'm reading chat, for instance, I'm facing away from the microphone. So I want to move the microphone over on this side of the camera instead, so that when I'm talking, it will still be, it will always be relatively more in front of me, so that sound levels don't fluctuate as much during a live stream. Timon says, what's the end goal with this ship? It is to make a new camera ship for myself. Office tour? There is an office tour on my channel. You can go ahead, you can search it up. It's a couple of months back, was done doing the whole lockdown, so you can go and you can find that video where we go over how the whole thing was built, because we did a complete rework. We put in like a loft above me here, and yeah. Does your office offer multi-crew? Yes, there's actually another seat right above me where my fiance works. Okay, let's try to let's figure out what we're gonna do with this power distributor. 11 seconds. How far could we go down if we just went full-on charge-enhanced super conduit? 5 seconds. Okay, so that's what we're... So what is the boost interval? Is it 9 seconds, I think? I think it's around 9 seconds. That's optimal. Can we get it to 9 seconds? I can't remember. Can somebody in chat remember that? What is the... How long does the boost last? 9 seconds seems long. But why engine focus? So 7 seconds, people are saying. I think it's gonna be 2A. Because engine focus, while it does give us extra capacitance, I mean, I can boost more times. If I go charge enhanced, ideally I want to have the continuous boosts. On the other hand, if I have more capacitor, I could just easier get into the station. 8 seconds with a 2A. You know what? I think I'm going to settle for that. So what can we do in here? The FSD booster we can't do anything with. The fuel scoop 4A, I could potentially drop that down if we wanted a bigger shield, but I think that should be sufficient. This one currently has reinforced. Let's go ahead and change that up to enhanced low power. And we could go strip down or we could go fast charge. High cap maybe. We could go, let's go, how much does strip down give us in terms of jump range? 52.335, gives us nothing basically. It gives a little bit extra hit points, then I'm gonna go fast charge. We have that little cargo rack, we have all limpets. This one needs to be lightweighted. There's a bit of mass there to save, there we go, nice. And how are we doing for power? We actually have quite a bit of power headroom right now. So we could most likely drop the power plant down to a 3A. Overcharge. Low emission doesn't do anything with mass. That increases mass. That's enough. Oh, no, it's not. Oh, 7%. So what if I turn off the scanners? The wake scanner, the Xeno scanner, the manifest scanner. Can I turn I can't turn the wake scanner on. I could live with I could turn off the research limit controller and the recon limit controller as well. Still not enough. Then the only option I see is to drop this down to a B fast scan. See, just dropping that down to a B saves us so much power. Actually enough to keep everything running. So that might actually be what we're gonna do. Almost 54 with a full fuel tank. Good speeds. No, I'm gonna disable my hangar. I hate having to go in and turn that off every time. I would rather go and say all those scanners and those weird collector limpet controllers and the didn't I have two? Didn't I have four? They no, I only have the research. Why do I have a research? Oh, I have recon there as well. Turn that off already? I turned it off. Yes. Turn those four off would be... I could live with those so that I could just turn off the wake scanner. But I need to be able to have that thing on. Okay, that's an interesting quiz engine. Interesting. So 38 seconds is actually maybe not a bad idea. What if we took, I kind of like this. What if we took this and put a, search here. If we put a fuel scoop in here, it's going to take us forever to scoop anything. But in reality, how often am I going more than 270? This would allow us to fit a corrosion-resistant cargo rack in here. Can we do some more moving stuff around? Scoop to 5, booster to 4. Okay, I could compromise on the vehicle hangar. I am really considering just saying, if I lose an SRV, then I lose an SRV. I have to go back and restock and do the shoot again if I lose one. Size 2 shields. I don't think. Just check here. No, I can't run a size 2 shield. Yeah, I probably gotta keep the SRVs. I really like having those two. Yeah, I could remove the fuel scoop, but again, I don't want to be so reliant on my carrier that I have to jump that around all the time. What to remove here? The fuel scoop. Okay. Okay, let's just try to go ahead and refine the Phantom build as well, so we get a little bit, because this is now to a point where this is okay. But with a 2 booster, I'm not going to be able to get that much jump range out of that, am I? Just shy of 50. And then you're considering a scoop here, 5 scoop. A little low on jump range, a little bit lower than I like. I know it's silly that it's, but still we lost like 3 light years. No, I'm not gonna downgrade my fuel tank. I mean, we know we can scoop this in no time. Anyway, let's just go and refine the Phantom, then I'm gonna work around all this here in a second. We're gonna go low enhanced and fast charge, like within the other one. Collector, recon, and research. We're gonna drop this down so we can just boost again, keeping an eye on our boost times to the 16 seconds. That's way too long. What was this on the Dolphin? 8 seconds. Let's try to see if we can get it about the same with this. No boost. Oh, no. Charge enhanced. Engine focus then. 10 seconds. We need a little bit more. Gonna get down to around the 8. Can I go now? Now I can boost and I'm down to 6 seconds. We could maybe drop this down to a D-rated. For mass. No boost there. Let's swap this over to engine focused. 8 seconds. 8 seconds. Okay. And I'm not lightweight to some of the controllers. Ooh, I did this over here, right? Yes, I did. But I haven't done here. Yeah, you're right. I just wanted to get the power distributor running. Power plant, we're going to look at that in a second. Vehicle hangar, that one needs lightweight. You're right. Yeah, I know you can boost, but I want the charge times around the 8 seconds. Look at that jump range though. Oh. Yeah, how low can I go on my shields? I can go down to a 3. And then low and that here I can now put a corrosive resistance in. So now this is actually pretty good also. Good jump range. Very good jump range. Speed is also very, very good. And we're gonna do the same thing with the armor here. Even though I do like dolphin build, this feels a little bit more comfortable. And we can have some, we have some room to play with the power plant. Let's just go ahead and let's turn some of the stuff on that off that we don't really need that often. Sort this by power. Turn all that stuff off. I need to have the frameshift weight scanner on, because that's the one I'm going to turn off in order to turn any of these modules on. Sensors, collect a little bit more to collect a little bit online. Good. Good, 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 good. Still not enough for the power though. We have to go back to a 4. Overcharged. Which we can go... Go overcharged like what, like 1? Is that enough? No. Overcharged 2. Overcharged 2, 99.9%. And then go thermal spread. Dolphin is cheap. Yes, I know the dolphin is cheap, but money is not an issue. I mean, I only have 6.3 billion on my in my character wallet. And how much do I have on my fleet carrier? 3.1 billion on my fleet carrier. And I have an alt with 5 billion that I haven't bothered moving over on this account yet. So, I mean, I don't care about the price. I have enough money in Elite to buy whatever I need. $21 million and $100 million. Yeah, okay. Three A overclocked on the power plant is more than enough. No, we just checked that, didn't we? It's not enough. We're 10% short. Even with Monstrate, we're short. How do we move credits from one account to another? You go to your own fleet carrier, and then I set up a sell order for low temperature diamonds, which I have on my fleet carrier, for the maximum possible price, which is like 2.5 million per ton. Then I go over to my other account, dock on my own fleet carrier, and buy those diamonds off the market. And then I go back to my other account and I set up a buy order for the same low temperature diamonds. But at this time, I set up the buy order at minimum, so at the 5% market cost. And then I sell them back to the fleet carrier at minimum price. And then I do the whole cycle again. Then I go ahead and I set them up for sale on the carrier at maximum price. And I do that loop over and over and over again until all the money's been transferred. It's on my scrap account. It's one of those accounts that I reset all the time. And even though I do have plenty of money on my main account, then I don't feel like throwing away 5 billion credits.
I think we're gonna go Foy. Overcharge 3. Double spread.
I like that. Do you limit who can duck to stop others grabbing them? Well, people are more than welcome to grab them. Remember, when I set up a sell order, I set them up for sale at 2.5 million credits per ton for low temperature diamonds. If there's anyone in chat who wanna buy low temperature diamonds off me for 2.5 million per ton, then raise your hand. Because then I have a good deal for you. And if people come in later and I have the buy order set up, well, if you have low temperature diamonds and you want to sell them to me for like a few thousand credits per ton, then you're also more than welcome. Please be my guest. It's more difficult if I have to move money from the account owning the fleet carrier and away, because then people, they don't have to do the opposite, right? I have to set them to sell at minimum. And then people could come in and they could buy those off the carrier. So what I would do in a situation like that, if I ever have to transfer money from my main account to one of my old accounts, is I would make sure I have all my EDSM connectors closed, so I'm not updating my carrier location or the market on it. And then I'm gonna jump it somewhere, dead end system, middle of nowhere, where there's no people, and then basically do the transfer out there, and then you can jump it back. And of course, while you do that, you close it off so nobody can get on it. You maybe don't have to jump it, actually. You can just close so nobody can dock on it. That doesn't matter. Okay. I actually like this build quite a bit, I must admit. Yeah, I could, Mike. Or I could open up so everybody could dock on the carrier, dock my alt, and then close so nobody can dock. Then he's already there, and yeah. If you're already docked, then you could. But again, this is really only an option. This is really only a problem if I'm transferring money out of that account. That I will, but I've never really had the need for that. But maybe I do in the future, I don't know. No, you can't kick people off. So if people are already docked, then yes, then they could potentially steal the diamonds. Sorry, Doug Lola, I did see that. Why do you rule out a size 5 power plant with a low emission thermal spread? They necessarily didn't, but... Oh, right, it has lower mass. No, it has higher mass. But your argument is we have so much jump range already that it doesn't matter. Yeah, 5. We can't go low emission 5. We can probably go low emission 4. Make that work. Low emission 4 monstrous, maybe. That would work. Yeah, but again, it's not an exploration build. I'm scooping a full tank. So I'm scooping 400 light years in just over half a minute. Yeah, but again, half a minute for a full tank. Remember, this is not an exploration build. It's a bubble boss. I would rather have that extra light year of jump range by going 4, overcharged 3, and then thermal spread. Again, 400 light years. I don't need to scoop. If I need to go more than 200 light years in either direction, I would probably move my carrier, to be honest. Okay, you know what? I actually really like this. This is a pretty decent build. I just want to check the Crate Mark II. Because it could... I'm just going to quickly do a quick test. We're not going to do the full everything on this one, unless it turns out to be interesting. I just want to do a very rough test. We're going to wait with that for a second. Just put like that in there. Increase range mass manager, thrusters, A with whoops. A with dirty drives, and direct drives, and put a big power plant in. We're going to adjust the C. Just going to compare this to the Phantom we have. Manifest, Xeno, Wake. We're going to put a Frameshift Wake Scanner. Just put an A rated in to start with. We're going to put a Xeno Scanner in and a Manifest. Manifest. And we're going to derate the Manifest right away. I'm going to put fast scan on that, and just put a fast scan on this as well. Okay, here we need, whoops, here we need a surface scanner in the class 4 slot. We need a planetary vehicle hangar. What else do we need? We need the limpet controllers. Recon. Let's make this a, oh, no. Actually, let's put this up there and make it a 3 recon, and then put the research limpet, and then put the, whoops, and put the collector, 3A collector in there. Let's lightweight that one. Because it's a camera ship, sometimes I want to do videos where I record scanning different things, so I put lots of scanners on it. Yes. Cargo, corrosive cargo. How are we doing for jump range? Not too good. We can probably work with this a bit. So the problem here is I really want to have to see if I can squeeze in a fighter hangar. How big or how small can I get the fighter hangars? In a class 5 slot. Throw that in there. It is a heavier ship, I know. We have lots of power, and that means that we can dump that power plant and save a lot of mass there. So we might actually be able to not get up on Phantom levels, but we might be able to get up to the 50. So what do we need? What did I forget? Fuel scoop and shield is still missing. So a fuel scoop. And oh, and I also need, no, it's not gonna work because I also need cargo. So that means I need to get rid of the research limpet controller and then make this one a recon limpet controller, one there, drag this down there. This gives me, can I put shield here? Yes, I can. Low emission, fast charge like that. Shields are pretty weak. Let's just put some heavy duty deep plating on that one. Actually, pretty much the same. So that was shields. I just need cargo now. Is there anything I could upgrade? Would there be any point in upgrading the fighter hangar? To get two bays? It's twice as heavy. So I think we'll actually keep that. But it seems like a waste to put that in there. Scroll up there a bit, sorry. I mean, there's nothing else I can really put in that class 6 slot than that corrosive cargo. Now let's do this one. Now we're gonna begin to strip some mass off the ship. You see, we're already now, without engineering here, we can probably strip this down to, what size the engine is, 6. And on this one, it was also 6, so that means we need a 3D engine focus super. Got. So we could put the same on this. 3D, that's like 80 tons of mass we just stripped off of 78. With engine focused and super. Oh, collector here. Oh, that is already lightweighted. 8 seconds, exactly. Perfect. So now we need to sort this by power. We need to have the wake scanner, but that one. I can turn on the fighter hangar when I need it. Turn all that off. And now we can begin to dump this one. What did we end up doing on the ship over here? We ended up with a size 4 overcharged thermal spread. So let's see how that works here. Overcharged 3. And we'd have to go with actually Monstret if we want to run that. And that would technically be it. Because then I could take the wake scatter offline. Or turn any of these on when I needed it. Because I don't use these that often. Actually, I would like to have the fighter hang online if it was possible. Is that possible? It is possible. Nice. This is not terrible. Oh, there we go. It's a little bit of everything. It's also senior research. What do you guys think? I mean, so let's just compare these two. Speed-wise, it is slightly slower. Jump range-wise, we lose about 8 light years of jump range compared to my current Anaconda build, which is a very long jump range and carries all this stuff as well. Not as good. You really like the dolphin. Yeah, the only thing missing here is here. Okay, so I get a better jump range and I get the research limpet here. But what I get on the crate. Oh, right. Hold on. I can actually do something here because now that I have a fighter, I don't need these big heavy thrusters. I can downgrade this to derate it. I could potentially go even like all the way down there, but I don't want to punish myself like that. So I'm going to go 6D with dirty drive drag drives on those. Yeah, but now that I have a fighter hangar on the Mark II, I don't necessarily need the big thrusters. I think a good point if we're gonna go do guardian stuff, then having a point defense could be fun. And with the downgraded thrusters, we can then also downgrade the power plant to probably a 3A overcharged thermal spread. Ooh, no, we couldn't. We can do 4. Overcharged, how much do we need? 2? Oh, that's not overcharged. Overcharged 2, yep, overcharged 2 thermal spread will fly. Boost time is the same. So it's, of course, with the downgraded thrust, it's significantly slower. The jump range is now up there. It's pretty good. Total range is also less. The only thing we really gain here is we lose the research limpet and we gain that fighter hangar. Yeah, it's still 8 seconds. The scoop times are the same. No SRV. There's an SRV. What? There. Planetary vehicle hangar. Yeah, I don't really think I need the research hangar. A research hangar. The research limpet. The research limpet is for collecting tissue samples from Thargoids. Again, I'm sorry, but the Dolphin 49. I kind of like the Phantom, to be honest. I need the fighter hangar because I'm using those as camera drones. That's why if I have the fighter hangar, I can downgrade the thrusters because I don't need the big thrusters for good maneuverability, but I need something that has good maneuverability to move around when I'm shooting shooting video. No cargo for those limpets right there, and on the Phantom it's right there. There is cargo. Cargo right there. You're going to see it here. Cargo, 60 tons. Cargo, 60 tons. Plenty of cargo. We have a checklist. Fuel scoop? Yes. 2 SRVs? Yes. Shields? Oh, yes, they're there, but... manifest scanner? No, hold on. Cargo. Shields, yeah. Cargo. That's where we're at. Cargo, yes. Detail surface scanner. Detail surface scanner, DSS, not DSD. Yes, we have that. Frameshift wake scanner, yes. Recon limpet controller, yes. Collector, yes. Manifest scanner, yes. Research, no. If that is also under if has room. Xeno scanner. And a kill one scanner. We don't want a kill one scanner, we put point defense in instead. Why don't we put point defense here as well? Point defense, that's really nice when you... Plenty of power for that. Okay. Here's what I'll do. I will say these are probably one of the two that I'm going to be working with. Dolphin, maybe. I don't know. So I'm going ahead and I'm going to gonna bookmark all of these. And I will also post them in chat because I saw some people were asking about it. So there will be links in chat here in a second. Just give me a moment. Yeah, we can also do that. We can just share them over on Discord. That'll probably be easier. There's a chat over there. Let me just find it here. Stream chat. Yes, all the way at the bottom there's a stream chat, and over there I will now begin to generate shorthand links for all of the builds, and they will be on Discord. So you guys can go. Ooh, bad request. That one worked. It's because I can only do one at a time, maybe. Okay, start by posting the. No, that didn't work. Okay, I'll have to do it from this end then. Okay, I'll have to post this after the stream then, because I can't get this up and running. It's on the other monitor. But after the stream, I will be sure to post links for all the builds here. What time is it? Okay. For all the builds here on... try the hauler. The hauler does not have enough internal slots for that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Nope. Not enough. We can barely make do with 7 internals. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Last one allows us to put in like FSD boosters. We have tried the DBX earlier and that was scrapped. It didn't really work that well. Do point defense really help when farming guardian stuff? Yes, when the skimmers shoot missiles at you, they can be shut down by your ship's point defense. Axel says, I got a Discord message from someone who led me to a different Discord group. Is that trustworthy? Probably not. I don't know who sent that to you. If it's just a random sending you Discord invites, then probably not. I would think that I want to try and build this. I like the Phantom. I like the middle. Hold on, let's check one thing here. Here we go. These are the rotation times around the different axes on the ships. Let's just check that. Just, you know, for fun and giggles. And also for the dolphin. Okay, so here we have roll 120. This is not. There we go. 120 on the dolphin, 25 on the Phantom, so it rolls faster than the dolphin, and 13 on the crane. This over here is pitch. So again, we have 36, 36, 23. And the last one down here is yaw, 24. 14. The Phantoms just can't yaw, apparently. Fourteen there, 13 there. Okay. Good. I have them bookmarked. Let's jump in. Let's go ahead and let's build ourselves a. Yeah, I think you know what, I was considering what ship I should bring, but I'm just gonna turn on game audio. There we have it. I think it's suiting that is the camera conda that takes me to build its replacement. Yes, I have built Phantoms before. My old account, my exploration account, is actually running around in a Phantom doing exploration. Oh. No, I actually haven't. ask what other people use for camera chips. So this one's called the Camera Conda, which was kind of... Come on, mash lock. There we go. You know what? Doesn't Red have a Phantom? Hold on. I think Red... Yes. I think it's Red that has a camera that's actually called Phantom. So it could be fun to call it Red Phantom. My hood ornament. What hood ornament? Like the D3A letters, or what are you talking about? Or the small thing at the front? Yeah, those cameras are crazy expensive. Those are professional cinematic camera. Jack, thanks a lot for the raid and welcome to all the viewers. What a chat. You get a juice box. You get a juice box. And you get a juice box. Phantom is a brand. Right. It's not Red that has a camera that's called Phantom. It's a camera brand. It's the high speed, that's right. And they also have drones. DJI has something called Phantom. Phantron. Is it Phantron? Yeah, okay. It is Phantron. That's not right. That's not it. Okay. I have to look that up at some point. I thought Red had a camera called Phantom, but I might be wrong. Third link on Google? Probably not. Phantom, okay, yeah, they do exist. Yeah, these are the one. Let's go ahead and get this thing. I'm not gonna obviously fully build it today. We're just gonna see what I have lying around in terms of weapons. That's actually quite fun, Darkseid. I didn't realize that. That Phantom, the company Phantom, makes high-speed cameras. And I have what I would consider a high-speed camera ship. So that's actually there's a joke in there somewhere, and I have to like. I have to go and look what the different camera models are, and then probably I'll name my ship after that. Yes, Robert, we did look at the Beluga, and it's too big, and I know that I would get annoyed having to fly in with those spoilers through the docking hatch every time. There's definitely a lot of convenience factor in my choice of ship. Deployed. Oh, I've got to overshoot. I always overshoot. No? There we go. There it is. What type of controls do I use? HOTAS. I could get used to this. We have to do a very important thing before we begin building, though. And that is... Whoa, wow. Head in here. Do we have any paint jobs for this? I have some. Are there any good ones? Right, they have these at the moment. They look kind of cool. I want something with a more... Not that one. Something with a more green tint to it. I don't just want the vibrant green. I don't like that. Oh, that's also the graphite. That's pretty cool. This one I kind of like. Gonna take that to start with. Weapon detailing, not that it really matters. We don't have much in terms of that. Oh, I just do this with a mouse, this is faster. Engine detailing. Decals. Ship kit? Do I have the ship kit for this? I do. We can get like a extra fin or two extra fins or four extra fins. I don't like this one because the way they are tilted inwards. Could go with a spoiler. I think either the spoiler or that... Just a fin. Because more spoilers, yes. Wings. No, no, no. No. That looks silly. I don't like the wings. I gotta go with no wings. Tail. Nope. Meh. Is that too much spoiler? I kind of like that, but then I want to swap this one out with the big fin. Bumper. If we're going to take a bumper, it's going to be those. Because the others take my field of view, and I don't want that. So then I gotta go no bumper. Now, this was actually the important stuff that I wanted to do. No, this is not. Nah, this is the nameplates. Okay. Oh, this needs to be a darker color, doesn't it?
Yeah.
I don't know what the ship's gonna be called yet. I'm gonna figure that out later. Oh, no, 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 no. The most important thing is Carlos. Oh, hold on. This is not going to be centered, is it? Nope. Great. There we go. And then just have a little, no, not string lights. Put a little planet Earth out there on the side. Just because. Beautiful. Now we can begin building. Hard points is easy. Yeah, I could change the E in the D2A with the Earth globe. I do that with some of the others, but it's more the bubble-heady kind of letters. But I think with the holographic one, it doesn't look that good. If there was a holographic Earth, I would put that in. Okay, hard points. We just did that. Utilities. Let's just see here. Wake scanner. Yes, good. Just gonna check. I have a lightweighted wake scanner. That's a really, really weird engineering on a wake scanner. And it's A. Do I need A? I need B. Why? Why do I have them lightweighted? Okay, I have to clean up. This is really okay. Never mind. You know what? I'm gonna. Okay, let's just keep them for now. I guess I'm gonna clean that up later. But wake scanner, B rated. Hold on. Actually, did we end up? Yes, we did end up needing the B rated. Good. And then manifests, Xeno, and point defense. Manifests, which was D-rated. Xeno. Experimental, I guess. And point defense. Is that a good position for point defense? No, it's not. Where would be a good position to point defense on either side, I guess. Underneath the ship is not, at least. It's not going to do much good there, so we're just going to go and transfer and swap that with the manifest scanner. Core internals, let's check. 4A. And the rest are full-sized. Okay. Do I have a 4A? I do not have a 4A stored, so we have to make ourselves a new one. Oh. No heat sinks. Nope. Oh, check for stored modules first. I have nothing I can transfer, so that means I have nothing there. 6A thrusters. Frameshift drive. Nothing I can transfer. Buy myself a new one. Life support. I didn't go full-size power distributor, did I? 3D power distributor. I highly doubt I have that lying around. I have a 3A. And a 7D. Oh, I have a 3D. 3D charge enhanced. I need engine focus though. BD. Optional internals. Why does this come with so many cargo racks? Okay, 6A fuel scoop. Guiding FSD booster. Oh, not interdictor. Corrosion resistant cargo. Vehicle bay. Gotta put scarabs in another second. 3C bi-weaves. Low enhanced. I will promise you I do not have that. No. Shield generator. 3C bi-weaves. BA collector, there's a good chance I have that. BA collector with lightweight, great. And then a recon limit controller, a research limit controller, and a detailed surface scanner. Do I have a detailed surface scanner? I do, with expanded probe already. Let's transfer that. What do they need first? Recon. Recon limpet. That's it. At least that's a start. Oh yeah. Put SRVs in. Should we set up the... Yeah. The ship won't fly at the moment, so we're just gonna go ahead and turn some stuff off. And we don't need here while we're actually building it. Now it's offline, but still not with deployed, so we're just gonna turn some stuff off here. There we go, now it can fly. Yes, we have sold the lasers. I don't believe I have anything offensive on this ship at all. Let's just go ahead and let's paint the SRV. Which one do we not want? Get a green one, or we can get a pure gold one. That's so over the top. It's been a while since I've been looking into store. This was kind of matched the ship. Kind of like that one. The dark frame is also cool. There's another gold one. What's the difference between... Oh, this is... Oh, sorry, this is galvanized bronze. This is gold. Right. And this is what? Brass. Copper. God, they have a lot. Oh, they have made a new vibrant green. That's different from that green. What's the difference here again? Okay, so there's slightly less of the arms that are green, so it's almost the same, to be honest. I actually really like that one because it matches the ship. Let's get that. Here you go, Frontier. Weapon detailing. Ooh, decals. Just plaster that triple elite all over the place. And we're gonna set this up identical. Again, because if I lose one, it's supposed to look like the same as Aviv. There we go. When did I achieve triple elite? That's a while ago now. I can't remember. Last year, I think, at some point. Cooper has a good point here. Maybe you should have a laser in case you need to charge or activate something. So you're thinking like guardian things. I think it would be possible to just throw in a... we could take like this a small beam laser. Just put it in a small beam laser and then turn it off. Don't want to engineer it. You want a mining laser as well? Mining lands, even. We can put the mining lands. And can we power these off? So we take the mining lands. Yes, we can power off the mining lands. Can we actually keep that on? Can we keep it on together with the laser? No. We can power off the laser and keep that one, or keep the laser on, so we have that if we need it. That's not a bad idea. Let's do that. And then I need to... trade Phantom. Delete. There we go. Go ahead and quickly fit that. Do we have any small bases? No. I have mining lances, so I'm going to fit one of those. A few crypto scramblers. One size one beam laser. Transfer. Mining lands. So let's go ahead and turn that off as well. Actually turn the mining laser off. If I could find it. Oh, hold on. There it is. Still not enough. We haven't engineered, so we gotta take the laser off as well. There we go. Okay. Now we just need to engineer it. How hard can that be?
What time is it?
Okay, you know what? We're gonna do... We're gonna do one thing real quick. We gotta see how bad it is in terms of... Galaxy engineering. My crafting list. Isn't there like a clear list? Find nearest, add tech broker, unlock this synthesis to craft list, add blueprint to craft list. Do I have to go in and delete all of these one at a time? There should be like a, just clear the list for me, please. I don't think the amount of engineering we have to do is that bad. Though I am a little low on materials in some categories. Let's see how bad it is. Okay. Galaxy. Engineering. Okay, let's start from the top. Add blueprint to crafting lists. And I'm gonna go 10 here. And experimental is gonna be deep plating. We're gonna do that once. Add that one. Good. Power plant was a 3 overcharge with thermal spread. So we're gonna do none here, none here, and we want the thermal spread. Add that. Then we want standard thruster upgrade. Put that on the list. We want a standard FSD upgrade. Mass manager. Okay, while I'm doing this, this would be a good time for you to go down below the stream and click the like button, because that is really helping a lot, and at least if you enjoy the stream. Let me see here, life support, lightweight, and sensors need lightweight as well, so do those both now. Add blueprints to lists. Hold on. No, we're only going to do this to grade 4, because I don't want to go out to Colonia, and I haven't actually had this character run out there. Here we are, I'm going to do it to grade 5. Then we just need the power distributor, 3D. Did we fit a 3D? Did I do that right? I feel like I might have fitted that wrong. No, I didn't. Okay, good. Engine focused super conduit engines thrusters. No, power distributor. Where are we? Here we go. Engine focused power distributors. With super conduits. There we go. Boom. Plug that in. What else do we need? We need the shields, and that one was done, and that one was done. And then we need this over here for fast scan. So the shield, we needed a low emission 5 fast charge. Nope, not force block. Fast charge. There we go. Add that. And then just fast scan on the two scanners. Manifest. I know the materials for these are the same. But just for good measures, we're going to add them separately. There we go. Well, that is actually not too bad. I need some proto light alloys and some proto radio. So we just need to go to independent system in Boom and collect a little bit of high grades, and then we're done. That wasn't too bad at all. Well, that was easy. But that is going to be a future live stream. Yeah, this is the easiest high grade to get. This is really easy. And then, of course, there's a lot of flying around between engineers, but that's going to be in a future live stream. Because I think I'm going to call the stream for today. Remember that next week is also a shipbuilding live stream, but it's a little flipped around. Next week is the I Build Your Ships live streams, where you have a lot of people have already sent in submissions either with existing builds they have, where they want me to come with suggestions for if there's any optimizations to do. Also, people have sent in like silly ideas, which is also very welcome. There's one that's actually quite funny. He wrote a whole little backstory to it that I really like. But that's going to happen next week. So we're going to again have some fun with theory crafting some ship builds. And it's going to hopefully be a good laugh. If you have any suggestions, if you have a build you want me to look at, if you have any suggestion for like a fun, silly build, it doesn't have to be practical at all, just go ahead and send it to me. I can't promise, or I can say for certain I won't be able to get through all of them with the number of submissions already, but I'll try to get through as many as possible. In the chat, you will now find a whole host of links. You will find a link for Streamlabs if you want to donate to the channel. It is, as always, very much appreciated. Everything that comes in through either Streamlabs direct donations, or Super Chat here on YouTube or Patreon, all goes directly to buying equipment that allows me to make better looking sounding videos or more videos, something that I can optimize my workflow. So basically put out more videos, more live stream for you guys. And it goes completely 100% to that. So if you want to support the channel, there is a very good option. And of course, if you join on Patreon, you get a discount on the merch store, which you will also find a link for in the chat, where you can buy yourself a mug like the one I have here, or t-shirts, hoodies, sweaters, all the usual stuff. There's some pretty cool designs other than just, you know, my logo printed on a t-shirt, which I like as well. I have multiple of them myself, but there are some other cool designs that you might like over there. And finally, the most important link we need to talk about is Discord. If you want the links for the builds I've done today, the Dolphin, the crates, the two different crates, I'm going to post them over on in the stream chat over on Discord. And I will probably be hanging out over on Discord as well for a little bit after the live stream. So if you want to come by and say hi, I'll be there in about 5 to 10 minutes. Thanks a lot for watching. I know there was very little in-game. We barely did an undock from a station today, but I still hope you enjoyed it. And I really enjoy these theory crafting live streams. So yeah, thanks a lot for watching. And until next time, we'll see you guys in space.